Hello, everybody. This is Joel, the Nose, coming to you from Miami as usual. And I hope everybody's having a great weekend and relaxing. So today I'm going to be doing a review of the niche perfume or niche designer by the name of Mark Buxton and his 2012 creation, Devil in Disguise. There you go, Devil in Disguise. So this is a juice that I picked up, I guess, about a month ago from my local perfumery here in Miami called Ozme Perfumery, which you've heard me mention before, fabulous place. So this is a interesting, I guess, a very unique fragrance that I bought. And the backstory behind this is I was in Ozme probably, again, about a month ago, and I was looking for some more vetiver-based fragrances, which I'm kind of on a vetiver kick right now, seeing it seems to really relate well with my own body chemistry. So Maurice, the owner, turned me on to this. It actually was on discount. I think it was 30 or 40% discount because of whatever reason. I guess it's not selling as well for Mark Buxton internationally. So I, of course, based on the price, decided to go ahead and get it. This is a 100 ml bottle. And that is kind of the reason, the backstory about why I purchased it, because as you'll see in a second, this is a vetiver-based fragrance. Now, basically, just to give you a little background on the designer, Mark Buxton is British. He is a niche designer, but he's had a very, again, prolific career. If you look at his fragrances that he's done a whole bunch of stuff from the Comme des Garçons line, which is a very niche, you know, house, to Cindy Crawford, to Burberry, to Le Labo, to, I don't know if you've heard about the Renegade project, but this is a project he's done with Giza Schoen, who's done a bunch of also very high-end fragrances, and they created this kind of project where they're supposed to be a little bit more indie. Anyways, so he, you know, this is a guy who takes chances. He's more niche. He's done more popular ones, but this is one he did for his own brand, again, called Devil in Disguise. Came out in 2012. It's an eau de parfum. It is a classified as unisex. I would say, you know, it's unisex, but definitely lends more towards, I think, the masculine side. That's how I would see it. To get into the notes, the top notes are listed right on his website as rhubarb leaf and ginger, mid notes magnolia and neroli, base notes patchouli, vetiver, and musk. So we have a total of 7 notes here. And I gotta say, I like that. I like the fact that it's rooted in 3, and you got 2 in the mid and 2 in the top. I think it's very cool. I think that, especially for a niche house, I think that this is still goes through a nice composition, and it's not just this linear fragrance, even though it's very limited on the notes. So let's get right into it. As I showed you before, here's the bottle. You can see it's kind of like a cylinder bottle, round. Okay, you got the, you know, the batch information and everything down here. I think the bottle is very cool. You can see the cap is actually kind of cool looking. I will say the bottle's cool. The label is just kind of a cheap label that, you know, could have been printed on your home computer. So they could have done, I think, a little bit more with that, but give you a spray here. Okay, very nice. The spray is a little diffuse, so it's not like us, it's not a straight line powerful, it's a little bit more diffuse than some of mine, but it gives me a very good coverage, I would say. So let's get right into it here. The top notes, right when you smell this thing, this is one of the most on-point fragrances as far as the descriptions of the notes go to the actual smell of the fragrance. This, right from the beginning, the top notes are listed as rhubarb leaf and ginger, and that's exactly what you get here. And that's what's so cool about this. It's very unique. I get a ton of ginger. I get, if I were to allocate it, I would say it's maybe 3/4 ginger, 1/4 rhubarb, because the ginger, it's very fresh. It's very warm right from the beginning. It's the notes are very round, so you just feel like, again, like this warm, round bubble surrounding you of ginger. But you get, there's a tinge of sweetness from the rhubarb. So if you've ever tasted rhubarb pie, which is kind of famous here in the American South, and so I've had it before. It's kind of similar to strawberry, but different. So I'm not sure how popular rhubarb is around the world. But that's the thing. So I get about 3/4 ginger, 1/4 rhubarb. You get a little bit of a floral and spicy, which comes from that ginger. So that ginger, it gives you a whole bunch of stuff going on here. It's warm, it's spicy, it's peppery a little bit. And then I would say that if I had to describe this, have you ever seen, well, actually, I'm sure you've seen ginger ale. It tastes or it smells like a ginger ale. And specifically Werner's ginger ale, which was very big here. I think it actually comes from England originally. Not positive about that. I'll have to look into it. But maybe somebody can let me know in the comments. It smells like a Werner's ginger ale, but not effervescent and bubbly, more like a flat ginger ale. I know I'm getting very specific here, but I like to be specific. Remember, again, I am an attorney, so I have to be very specific with my word choices. And by the way, I was in court today, and I wore this in court, this fragrance today, this morning, and I won my hearing. So I'm going to attribute it to Devil in Disguise, because it made me a devil in disguise in court today. Another interesting thing about ginger, just to, in case you didn't know, ginger is heavily used in aromatherapy because of the energizing effect of ginger. And I would say whenever I wear this, and I've worn it probably 5 or 6 times now, it's a very energizing. That ginger, kind of like a ginger ale again, it's just very energizing. It feels like, you're like ready to run through a wall. So this is a great fragrance to wear for a big meeting, for a big event, maybe even a date, something you just want to get energy on. For me, for court today, it was very good. I would also say that there was a nice punch of sweetness that came from that rhubarb, but again, it was just a tinge, so that it was just like a punch. It was really nice. As you guys know, I always have my notebook, so I don't want to miss anything, so excuse me if I read from this sometimes. I would say then, about 1 hour in, there was still lots of ginger going on here. It was a little bit sweeter, which I think is coming from the mid notes, the magnolia and the neroli, which you know is kind of a citrusy, sweeter, a little bit sweeter smell. I would say that Mark Buxton is known for his very modern fragrances, and sometimes he gets criticized as being too synthetic. This did have a synthetic feel to me, but not in a bad way, not in a fake way, which if you read my or watched my review last night from the Tom Oud, or Tom Ford, the Tom Ford Costa Suda Aqua, that came across as very synthetic and kind of fake to me. This does not at all. It's very modern. It's not metallic. It's very warm. And let me tell you about this, which this is very interesting, because on my skin, this thing is a beast. It's a beast for the sillage and the projection. I mean, I feel like for the first 4 hours strong, I feel like I'm walking in a helmet or a bubble of fragrance. Everywhere I turn, because I sprayed it as I always do, by the way, I spray on the back of my left hand, I spray on the insides of my elbows, I spray once on either side of the neck and once on the back of the neck. And I felt like I was walking around. Whenever I would turn, I would get a waft, and I was in this bubble. And it's a great smell. Again, this unique ginger rhubarb, which is so different from typical fragrances that you smell out there. So I loved it. I love smelling my hand. I love the wafting. And this projection goes on forever, guys, on my skin. So I would say then, also at about that hour mark, the patchouli starts to kick in. The vetiver a little bit, but it's really more the patchouli for me. And again, I'm a vetiver freak. And so you would think maybe I was a little bit disappointed, because for me, the vetiver here wasn't as strong, but not at all. You can get it there, but it mixes in with the patchouli. And after the 2 hour mark, again, now it's really gone into the base and it's mostly patchouli. You get a little bit of that musk. and a little bit of that vetiver. So I would say probably it's, you know, half patchouli and then maybe a quarter vetiver and a quarter of a musk. The synthetic also aspect tends to come out a little bit more, maybe at that 3-hour mark. It's almost kind of like a brassy feel, I would describe it. Again, not bad or fake. I actually like it. It's just that's how I would describe it. Even at that 3-hour mark, this baby is still projecting. It's still giving me that sillage and that scent as I'm walking around. After the 4-hour mark, still projecting, but now it's mostly a strong skin scent. And this thing lasted all day. All day, it was on my skin. I got good 5 or 6 hours of strong, you know, even like I said, projecting around my body. It starts pulling in after about 4 or 5 hours. But for most fragrances to get that type of projection that long is really amazing, especially for the price I got for this on discount. This will last on my skin a good 10, 12 hours. By the end of the day, I'm still smelling it on my hand. It's still there and it's a wonderful smell. So in conclusion, guys, this is a wonderful ginger rhubarb at the top, which is for a good hour. You're getting that ginger and that rhubarb, like a ginger ale, like a Werner's ginger ale. And then you kind of go into a little bit of the sweeter mid notes. And, you know, again, of that kind of magnolia, a little bit citrusy, neroli, and then you go right into that patchouli. And this is, for me, a predominant patchouli for the rest of the day in the base. This is, I think, the dominant note probably that Mark Buxton used here is that patchouli. But it mixes well with the vetiver and the musk. I am a vetiver, big-time fan, and this one is, for me, a slight vetiver fragrance. It's not really predominant. Lasts all day. For me, over 10, 12 hours on the skin, and for 4 hours solid, 5 hours even, I'm getting a projection, and even up to the 6 hours, I could still smell it around my body when I would turn certain ways. So I mean, the you know, just chin and the lasting power of this is unbelievable. As far as would I buy this again, guys, as you know, who've been watching my videos, this is where I take to doing a dance if I think that this is going to be something that I would buy again. And yes! Yes. 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 This is worthy of a dance. This is worthy of me purchasing again. Once I run out of this bottle, if it's still around, I don't know. Like I said, it was kind of in the... had been pushed down to the quote discount bin at the niche perfumery house here. I hope you guys found this useful. I hope you found it entertaining. I hope you find a chance to go smell this. As I always say, go smell it first. Don't blind buy. Try to get a sample of it somewhere. If you found this useful, please leave some comments. Please subscribe if you haven't already. I really appreciate it. And I appreciate you those who have already done it. And I hope everybody's having a great, wonderful weekend, enjoying your family, enjoying some rest, and have a great day, everybody. Thank you. This is Joel, The Nose.